Hi. Okay, we're back. Now this must be part 8 of Dark Souls. Prepare to die. Or, in this case, prepare to turn off SSAO. I think it's SSA... Blah, 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 blah. Screen Space Ambient Occlusion. I noticed it was giving me some weird-ass shadows on the grass, which... You know, it might have looked better, but I wasn't used to it, and I think it was giving me a frame rate hit. Well, today we're going down to Blighttown to ring the second ding-dong thingy. Now, let's... What should we do? More dexterity? Yeah, let's, and then let's start pumping dexterity to 30. That'll do. That'll do nicely. As a matter of fact, we'll only take 1 point in this, so we can go all the way up to 19 dex. Lovely. Let's see if we can, no? Oh, that is a shame. But not to worry. How about... Actually, I'm kind of grateful we can't do that. I must admit. Let's try... Elite Knight. Very well. Sorcerer it is.
Oh. Hell, I'm considering I have a... That key.
Yeah, we already heard about that. Blighttown, which is down there. That's where we'll be. Very shortly. The reason we're taking a shortcut is because I don't like Blighttown. I don't think anyone really likes Blighttown. Now, this is the first time I've been here on the PC version, and although I'm recording, I will be interested to see if the frame rate holds up better than the console version, which I imagine it will. So we can take this shortcut because we have the master key that lets us through here. That is the main reason I suggest taking it. And you know what? We're not gonna fight the dragon, just to be on the safe side. This is normally the way out of Blighttown after you've defeated Kellogg's. Ah, I am getting some low frame rate. So we've raised our dexterity a bit, which means we're hitting them a little bit harder with our rapier. You can just run past these guys, and you probably should, but... Actually, you probably shouldn't. This is a chance that you could gang up on you and kill you. They can poison you, these guys can. And no one likes being poisoned. Ooh, right in the butt. And they apparently drop a poo when they die. Yeah, I'm not even gonna comment on that. I believe these things are called infested barbarians or something. Ow. That hurt. One thing we're going to want to equip here is definitely we're going to want blooming purple stuff. Because this area of the game is full of enemies that poison you. Ah, not just poison, but toxic poison crap. We don't need that, but we'll take it anyway. And now we're going to... If you remember, we picked up a short bow earlier. Now we're going to use that and some of the poison arrows we grabbed. Oh, and if you're having trouble navigating Blighttown, always look for the torches. Those will lead you to where you gotta go. So let's swap to poison arrows. Now let's poison this. You know, I don't even know what this thing's meant to be, but let's kill it. There we go. So this poison should, in theory, kill it if we're lucky. Now we don't need to kill it, but it's guarding a what's it guarding? Oh yeah, power within. And we will want power within. Will we? Actually, we probably won't. I don't know what I'm talking about. But it's a useful skill to have. And, you know, we might pick it up, actually. For, later. So here we have very irritating poison dart guys. Thankfully, they don't respawn, which is very good. You might be wondering why I'm not instantly curing the toxic. That's because in my current gear, they'll just do it straight to me again. So I'll kill them first, and then I will detoxicate myself. Let's go and do it now. Close. Too close for comfort. The last one normally falls down. And I think he has. Which is good. Because, we want to fight him down here. And we're coming over here because... Ooh. There's an item we want over in the corner. Yes, you can jump. Even when I'm not actually attacking you. Ah, whatever. You know, it would really suck if we got invaded here. It would really suck. Oh, did I? Ah, what a git. Where? Where's the rascal? Oh, he's right over there. What a... Yeah, yeah, whatever. And this actually looks like it might be a dead bonfire keeper. Which is a little odd. But hey, perhaps there was once a bonfire there. And if you remember in... Was it last episode or the episode before that? Well, if you remember when we fought Gaping Dragon, the weird Cthulhu vagina beast creature, it, I mentioned that it crawls up from Blighttown, and those sort of the waterfall style thing that it climbed up was probably some sort of sewer system. And, that, I believe, I know where it climbed up from, and I'll show you that place momentarily. Hop. Stab. I don't like this plank, so I stab it. Well, this is a pretty rubbish frame rate, but I've been getting 15 frames per second a lot whilst recording anyway, and I have absolutely no idea why. Hopefully it doesn't come across too much in a YouTube video. I mean, Oh, that scared the shit out of me for a second. I thought it was an actual invader. But no, it's just Mildred the fatty thing. Supposedly an in-joke amongst the developers. Which is why she's so weird. Sorry, Mildred. No time for you today. Mildred drops us some, what does she drop us? Oh, a butcher knife and some humanity. See, that is weird. As soon as I go to the bonfire, it refreshes not only my Estus flasks and health, but apparently my frame rate. Makes complete sense. So I think this is where the gaping dragon crawled up from. Why I think that is because I believe it roughly lines up with where that is, and also a dragon scale. It just seems odd that there would be a dragon scale here for absolutely no reason. So we can't really see up there all that well, but and it probably just fades to black eventually, but I am of the impression that this leads up to the gaping dragon. Although this, I don't know if it would even fit in this circular room, but who knows. That is what I think happened. Just my opinion, of course. Now let's equip some of this, and let's level up our... Oh, I don't know if I want to level up my strength. It's, you know what, let's just go with 20 dexterity, why not? K-Lag is probably going to take us quite some time to defeat, as we don't have any high damage weapons, we don't have any magic, and we don't even have any phantoms to summon. But it's probably because, actually, we were about the right level, I would say. Level 30 for K-Lag seems about right to me. But, you know what, that's okay. We are increasing the damage from our longsword with dexterity. As well as, although that's not the main reason we're doing it. And we'll have a look and we'll see if, Kaylana, I believe her name is. Yeah, poison. Is she there? I don't think she should be, as we've not really done anything. No. I'll talk more about her later. What? Oh, I hate those eight flies. You can basically infinitely roll if you time it like this, but you can also run and go like that to regen your stamina a bit, but I believe it's faster just to roll. That's nice, we didn't lose too much health. Now, should we swap some gear out? Let's see. We want fire defense. Fire. What gives me fire? This gives me fire. And it weighs... Oh, that actually weighs the same. That's interesting. Fire. Oh, that gives us more too. That's great. Maybe we can afford to equip this. Ah, that's brilliant. We look like a complete pillock, but, you know... That's not a big deal. We could have actually gone and picked up the Pyromancer set. Maybe we should have done that. Ah, who cares. Let's summon the chick we just killed. Because why not? And let's go in. Not even Arik wants any of this, trust me. Oh boy. Yeah, we're not... We ain't hurting her at all. But neither is she hurting us. Yet. If you stick, like, to the left of her, you are generally safe. But the main attack of hers that kills me is the fire explosion, which she's probably going to do momentarily. Yep. Oh. Fortunately, it didn't hit us that time. Now, just out of interest, where the hell is... What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? Get your fat ass over there and do something. Thank you. What a genius. What an absolute genius. Yeah. Sometimes summoning help can actually just do nothing helpful whatsoever. But hey, she does some nice damage. We'll let them play together for a bit. 98 damage that did to her. It probably would have one-shot me. Yes, Mildred can split it wide open. Somebody mods Metal Gear Revengeance on PC when it comes out so that Raiden has Man-Eater Mildred's model, that would be pretty good. Just saying. This isn't very exciting, is it? Yeah, I was standing in the lava to make it more exciting. Kill steel! Rectard. Ah. Yep. What do you want, Mildred? I stole your kill. That's what I thought. Wait, so Kaleg actually gives less souls than the Gaper? The Gaper, that... That sounds so wrong in so many ways. Well, and you know what? Now we're on our way to Anor Londo. Plondo. Plondo. Maybe we should do Ceaseless as we're here. Yeah, you know what? I think we will. What a suspicious wall. Whoa. Hello.
Oh dear. What have we here? Are you a new servant?
Sure, whatever.
But you have no eggs.
Ooh, I almost kicked him then, which would have been bad with a rapier because... Yeah, that ain't a kick. Move your freaky egg ass. It's, I know I really shouldn't keep on leveling this stuff, but... Yeah, okay, I've really been pumping my defense on this character. Which is weird, because I normally don't do that, but... Why is it that my frame rate keeps going up to 30 every time I'm... That is... Whatever, I'm just confused by this game's performance. It's so weird. I should have kept my other gear on because we're gonna need the fire defense, but... Ah, whatever. So... That's who we're going to be fighting now. Ceaseless Discharge. And I know that is a really weird name. Ooh. Close. I think this is the only point in the game where you can see two bosses at the same time who aren't like the gargoyles. That thing... Okay, I just realised that even if I point at the screen, you can't see it, but where the tip of Sivamont's longsword is pointing, that is the centipede demon. We'll be fighting him a bit later. And that... Okay, you can't really see him that well, but that is Ceaseless Discharge. Gross name, gross boss, but we're gonna take him out now, in theory. First off, we're gonna put all the fire defense gear we can hold. And yes, I already had that equipped, but I'm stupid. And here we are in the Demon Ruins. Lovely place. Once a city, perhaps, who knows. Was Izalith a city? Perhaps. All we know is that it's called Lost Izalith, and home to the Witch of Izalith. So it was probably a city of some description. So there are many ways you can fight Ceaseless, and yeah, you can fight him the normal way, but I don't want to. Look at this ugly face. I don't want to be fighting him any longer than I have to be. So what we're going to do... This is one of his deceased sisters. And because Sivamont is illiterate and also a bit of a prick, he's going to pillage her corpse. And then he's going to run like fuck. That can happen. That's okay. That's why I was raising my my stats, but well, that ceases discharge for you, and that's why I don't like to fight him the normal way. Because he one-shots you, even when you've been pumping vitality. But, to be fair, you're not really meant to fight him yet, but I like to get rid of him now. And now I don't have much choice, because I am not losing the staggering, like, two souls I had. Actually, it's more that if a boss kills me, I will refuse to give up, and I will just keep fighting it until I beat it. In this case, I'm not even technically fighting it, but, you know, whatever. So, now this is the right pickle we're in. We're in the right place, but what he's gonna do... shouldn't have done that. He's not gonna do what we want him to do, is he? Nope, he's not. He's just gonna do this. Jesus, Louises. See, that ain't what we want to happen. Because he's just gonna stand there and he's gonna spam that attack. Ah. Christ. Leave me alone, you giant pestering poo. Some of the bosses in this game are just not fun to fight whatsoever, and they're just... Oh. He toasted my ass. Not very nice of him to do that. Huh. So, we're not only running back here to recover our souls, we're also trying to reset him. So we need him to be sort of chasing us for our plan to work. Look at him, he looks so stupid. I'd be sad too if I looked like that. I'm not quite that diseased looking. Oh, see, I tried to roll that, but I was slow. Yeah, come on. Are you gonna roast us again? Very good. Come on, stand up. Okay, hopefully this time it's gonna work. If not, I'm just gonna screw it and come back much, much later. It can be so random sometimes whether you survive or not, I swear. I'm sure I've done this with less vitality and survived. Ooh. Ow. We stacked on our face. I don't think this is gonna work. Come on. Ah, good. So, right now he's hanging over the edge. We've made him jump over here. See, look how much damage we're doing to him. I mean, obviously we did that much, but we weren't doing any damage whatsoever. Which is fair, because we're using a +5 longsword, but all the same, you know?
Fire! Nice touch.
So he's dead, and he's now stopped excreting foul juices. Now we're going to go back to Firelink's Shrine. Then we'll call that episode for today. And tomorrow we shall go to the Fortress of a Thousand Traps, also known as Sentence Fortress. And that big dome with all the branches coming out of it is Izalith. And the Bed of Chaos. And let me tell you, the Bed of Chaos is just a barrel of laughs. I hope there is not anything remotely like that in Dark Souls 2. It's not fun, it's not challenging, it's just rubbish. But hey, it's like one boss in a game with... I don't actually know how many bosses it has, I'd have to count. It's got a good number. Oh, and this, I didn't really talk about her. That is Kaylag's sister, who... Yeah, we killed her sister because we're nice. She's pretty massive. And she can't understand what we're saying. Her covenant is the Chaos Covenant, which sounds like crazy and evil, but it's more chaotic in the literal sense of the term. I'm gonna sneeze, I think. Or not. I was sort of desperately looking down at my microphone to see if it has a mute thing. So you can actually speak to her, and some players call her the Fair Lady, some call her Kaylan, I think, something like that. But if you have the Old Witch's Ring equipped, you can speak to her, and she assumes that you are Kaylag, her sister, because they are the only two who can speak in that ancient tongue, presumably, that she knows of. And we're back in Blighttown. Not for long. Huh. What's this? Boss? Sure, why not? Hop. So, maybe you've been noticing the custom thumbnails for these videos, which is original art, of course, nothing less for Sivamon. Not drawn by me, because I cannot draw to save my life, but it was coloured in by me. That sounds like something a 10-year-old would say about some, yeah, whatever. But a friend of mine, she drew it for me after I pestered her much to do so. And she wasn't too pleased with it, but I used it anyway because I wanted to use it like that. And if you didn't know what it is, it's Dio from Last Exile, dressed up in some Dark Souls armor. You might not recognize the armor, and that is understandable because it's, well, for one, it's the wrong color, but you know, you'll see why later. As for why Dio, why not? I like Dio. That's my, he's also on the icon avatar type thingy of the YouTube channel. If you haven't seen Last Exile, you should. It's not really that amazing of an anime, but it's worth watching for several reasons. It's a flawed gem, perhaps. And Dio is by far the best character. And one of the best characters, I do believe. You know who else is a good character? Not that giant testicle worm thing. Damn it, I was hoping that thing would be dead. Ah, whatever. Maybe we'll kill him later. Obviously, the poison didn't. Oh, that'd be because I went to the bonfire too fast. Ah, whatever. So, yeah, Last Exile's good. As for the actual Mont bit, you know, Silvermont or Sivamont in this case, that comes from, so, you probably don't know, but I am an author, and I have a book published. I should probably plug that, shouldn't I? Like, every single second. Buy my book, and all that, but, no, I have a book, and one of the protagonists in the book is called Montiel, or Mont for short, and, that has been the main sort of character I make in RPGs for close on 10 years now, since World of Warcraft, which is when I first made him. You know what, screw those fatties, we'll deal with them later. Actually, we won't, we'll never be coming back here, hopefully. But yeah, that's where the Mont thing comes from. As for Silver, well, at one point in the book, this character, who's a bit insane, has many pseudonyms, and one of them is the Silvermont. Because he brings, like, someone tells him that vampires are weak to silver, which they are in my book, be quiet. I don't care if that's normally for werewolves. And so of course he just brings like 20,000 silver swords with him. Oh. Oh dear. And yeah, a while back in Guild Wars 2's beta, I made that as my character's name because Mont was taken. And also, I had a friend who used to do the habit of, like, a friend you meet in real life, but they call you by your online handle, so he would always be saying, like, hey, Mont, and it was, like, I say like a lot, don't I? But, it was weird and amusing. Gasp! What is this treachery? What sort of... So, our firekeeper is dead. Laltrek killed her. He did her in. He wrecked her tots. Well, actually, he just wrecked her, but whatever. So, what do you have to say about that, huh?
Did you ring the second bell?
Yes, I did.
That is incredible, I must say.
Why didn't you stop Lautrec? Lautrec.
We have a new
Poo face.
It's noisy. It snores.
You git.
And its breath is lethal. This is no laughing matter, I tell you.
You plonker.
Damn. That stench. And I was really beginning to like it here. Maybe it's time I do something about it.
Yeah. What he will do about it is he will go down and hollow himself. Or maybe he attacks... Maybe he attacks the cause of the stench and it turns him hollow because... But we're going to save him from going hollow by doing this.
Lousy rat! You have some nerve. I may be crestfallen, but I'm not defenseless, you bastard! You will soon regret this!
He actually does a lot of parries, which is nice. And,
Not too shabby. Not too shabby. I think you've done me a favor.
Yes, we have. Now, that does count as a sin, but... Frankly, we did do him a favour. But what now? Our bonfire's gone. Oh, look who's back. Look who's back.
Oh, you again? Me? I've become separated from my lady.
Mm-hmm.
I've scoured near and far,
mm-hmm.
but no sight of her. Where could she have gone? My lady, to think I swore to protect you with my life.
Oh, Petrus. Four of you, and you couldn't even take on the catacombs. That's pathetic.
Oh, hello there. I'm pleased to see you safe, as always. If you provide the materials...
Why did nobody try and stop Lautrec? That, what the fudge is this? You might be wondering. And you would be right to think that, because what the fuck is that? What is it? What is it, bird? Eat it. Peck it. It's a worm. You eat worms, don't you? Apparently not.
Ah, hello. Was it you who rang the Bell of Awakening? I am the Primordial Serpent, King Seeker Fract, close friend of the great Lord Gwyn, chosen undead, who has rung the Bell of Awakening. I wish to elucidate your fate. Do you seek such enlightenment? By the lords, are you certain? Well, perhaps I was wrong. There can be only one chosen undead. I will continue my search. You are freed from duty. But then again, you did ring the Bell of Awakening. I will stay here a while. Speak with me if you should change your mind.
No thanks. I don't like Frampt. He's gross and big. But, you know, maybe we should speak to him, as he's gonna tell us what to do. Whoa, that's some dodgy texturing. Nah. We'll get to the bonfire and then we'll call it. I actually forgot the bonfire would be gone. Oh, we'll get some revenge. Yes, we will. Sivamon. I don't know. Something about Sivamon not wanting his firekeeper dead. He'll get his revenge eventually. And soon he will have some armor on. Hurrah. What is this? Try wings. Okay, I think this is gonna cool it. At least this bonfire is still here. I wonder why every bonfire doesn't need a keeper, but some do. Oh well. Righty-ho. Until next time.